Bonding. Bonding is something that keeps two things together. For example, marriage is a bonding between a man and a woman, which keeps them together legally. And the next one is agreement. Agreement is a bonding between two people, which keeps them together. So, bonding is something that keeps two things together. So, here we are going to see about types of bonding in chemistry that keeps atoms and molecules together. Atoms are held together in molecule by various types of bonds that depend on the valence electrons. By comparison, the molecules are attracted to each other by weaker bonds, which generally result from the electron configuration in the individual molecules. Thus, we have two types of bonding. One is primary bonds, generally associated with the formation of molecules. And the next one, the second one, is secondary bonds, generally associated with attraction between molecules. I repeat, primary bonds are associated with the formation of molecules, that is force within molecule, and secondary bonds are associated with attraction between molecules, that is between two or more molecules. So first let us see about primary bonds. Primary bonds are much stronger than secondary bonds. Primary bonds are characterized by strong atom-to-atom attraction. That is, within a single molecule that we involve the exchange of valence electron, primary bonds include the following forms. One is ionic and covalent and metallic. These three types are within primary bonds. Let's first see about ionic and covalent bonds. Ionic and covalent bonds are called intramolecular bonds because they involve attraction force between atoms within the molecules. First, let's see about ionic bonds. In the ionic bond, the atom of one element give up their outer electron, which are in turn attracted to the atoms of some other element to increase their electron count in the outermost shell to 8. In general, 8 electron in outer shell is the most stable atomic configuration, except for the very light atoms like hydrogen. And nature provides a very strong bond between atoms that achieve this configuration. The example is the reaction of sodium and fluorine to form sodium fluoride, illustrate this form of atomic bond. And other example is sodium chloride, that is stable salt, is a more common example. Because of the transfer of electrons between the atom, sodium and fluorine ions are formed, from which this bonding derives its name, ionic bond. Properties of solid materials with ionic bonding include low electrical conductivity, poor ductility. Next, the covalent bond is one in which the electrons are shared as opposed to transferred. It is not transferred, it is just shared between atoms in the outermost shell to achieve a stable set of 8. Fluorine and diamond are two examples of covalent bond. In fluorine, one electron from each of two atoms is shared to form F2 gas, as shown. In the case of diamond, which is carbon, atomic number 6, each atom has 4 neighbors with which it share electrons. This produces a very rigid 3-dimensional structure not adequately represented and accounts for extreme high hardness of this material. Other form of carbon, example graphite, do not exhibit this type of rigid atomic structure. Solids with covalent bonding generally possess high hardness and low electrical conductivity. The third one, which is are different from the two bonds that we saw. The metallic bond, the third metallic bond, is of course the atomic bonding mechanism in pure metals and metal alloys. Atom of the metallic elements generally possess too few electrons in the outermost orbits to complete the outer shell for all the atoms. In, say, a given block of metal, accordingly, instead of sharing an atom-to-atom basis, metallic bonding involves the sharing of outer shell electrons by all atoms to form a general electrical cloud that permeates the entire block. This cloud provides the attractive forces to hold the atoms together and form a strong rigid structure in most cases. Because of the general sharing of electrons, the freedom to move within the metal, metallic bonding provides a good example for electrical conductivity and other typical property of material characterized by metallic bonding include good conduction of heat, good ductility, and what else that we know about metals. Whereas primary bonds involve atom to atom attractive forces, here secondary bonds involve attraction forces between molecules or intermolecular forces. There is no transfer or sharing of electrons in secondary bonding, and these bonds are therefore weaker than primary bonds. There are three forms of secondary bonding. So the one is dipole forces, and the next one is London forces, and the third one is hydrogen bonding. So let's see one by one. Types, dipole and London forces, that is dipole and London forces, are often referred to as Vanderwaals forces. So the first two one is called as Vanderwaals forces after the scientist who first studied and quantified them. Dipole forces arise in a molecule comprised of two atoms that have equal and opposite electrical charges. Each molecule therefore forms a dipole. For hydrogen chloride, although the material is electrically neutral, its aggregate form on a molecular scale, the individual dipole attract each other given the proper orientation of positive and negative ends of the molecules. These dipole forces provide a net intermolecular bonding within the material. The next one, London forces, involve attractive forces between non-polar molecules, that is, the atoms in the molecule do not form dipoles in the sense of the preceding paragraph. However, owing to the rapid motion of electrons in orbit around the molecules, temporary dipoles form when more electrons happen to be on one side of the molecule than on the other side. You can see it in the image. This instantaneous dipole provide a force of attraction between molecules in a material, but this attraction is weaker than the atom to atom attraction. Finally, hydrogen bonding occurs. This hydrogen bonding occurs in a molecules containing hydrogen atom. If there is no hydrogen atom, then hydrogen bonding cannot be happen. So hydrogen covalently bonded to another atom, oxygen in H2O. Because of the electron needed to complete the shell of the hydrogen atom are aligned on one side of its nucleus, the opposite side has a net positive charge that attracts the electrons of atom in neighboring molecule. Hydrogen bonding for water and is generally stronger intermolecular bonding mechanism than the other two forms of secondary bonding. It is important in the formation of many polymers. So hydrogen bonding is one of the important bonds that play a very important role in chemistry.